Hello, welcome yet another episode of Campus Connect. This time we're indoors in the auditorium of JRE Institute, who've been kind enough for giving us space. Many thanks, JRE, and give a huge round of applause for the audience who's here in this particular audience. Now, this is an audience that is informed. The topic today on Campus Connect is one that I've been wanting to do for a very long time. 2014 elections, one of the most abusive elections ever. Are they? Can they be better, or will this be remembered, this particular election be remembered for its notoriety? Our guest tonight, introducing first, R.P. Singh of the BJP, please welcome him to the show. Diptosh Majumdar, National Affairs Editor, NewsX, many thanks for joining us. Completing the panel today, Aman Panwar, leader of the Congress Party, he's here, many thanks. And that's our fantastic audience. Starting with R.P. Singh, sir, opening statement, 30 seconds. Is this the most abusive election ever? And has your party and your supporters been equally culpable as the next guy?
See, I don't take this election as the most abusive election. I mean, only thing is the certain parties, yes, certain leaders, yes, they have gone, they have crossed the limits. And there has been reaction on those, when they have crossed limits, there has been reaction on that. Whereas my party goes, I'm on the court prepared to say that none of my leaders, none of my supporters have been used any abusive language. There could have been some reaction to something, but not as a first choice.
All right. Okay, let's take that at face value. I think many of you will not agree, but I'll come to you in just a bit. Aman Panwar, before I go to Diptosh, the Congress is equally guilty of harboring these people who speak the language of hate, as well as the next guy, the next party. Do you agree? Mr. R.P. Singh says his party is not culpable, maybe some leaders. Are you going to sing the same song to us?
See, what Mr. R.P. Singh has said, the rebuttal to that is there in the public domain. I need not respond to it, but I would like to say that elections essentially in India or in the world are fought only on the basis of past record, policies, or what the government or a party has to offer to public at large. The voter does not appreciate if a candidate or a political party gets into verbal spat with their opponents. So this practice is definitely liable to be condemned, and the Congress party, on behalf of Congress party, I state that any such act should not be appreciated, and they are anyway not appreciated by the voter
today. It's very easy to say that, and you would agree, politicians and political parties always say this, but what's behind it, what's the reality? Diptosh Majumdar, it's very easy to say that, this kind of verbal duels should not be there. Verbal duels is fine, but maintain civility at least. Our parties have failed at that.
I think this is my 31st year in journalism, 32nd year to be precise, and I've seen about 7 or 8 elections. This is the worst election ever as far as abuse is.
Who agrees this is the worst election ever? People who agree will say yes, abusive-wise.
Yes.
Yes. So the resounding response from the audience.
Beginning from, let me give you an example from both sides. Imran Masood of Congress, he says he'll chop Modi into pieces. And look what the Rajasthan When the Rajasthan MLA speaks, he says that Sonia and Rahul should be stripped and they should be deported from this country. Is this a language to come from either side? We expect a greater degree of civility. When political parties take up tough stances and are unwilling to come to a middle ground towards each other, then obviously we'll see such terrible abuses pouring and frothing from their mouths.
And that, of course, is the tragedy of our democracy. I'll finish with opening statements. I'll come to the audience right now. Questions. Who wants to? Yes. What's your name?
Basit.
Stand up. Yeah.
Sir, I have two questions. One from BJP and one from Congress. For BJP, I have a question is, Mr. Praveen Tugaria said that when he'll come into power, he'll take away voting rights from Muslims. And someone from BJP said that all those who are not voting for Modi should move to Pakistan. Is this responsible politics? Are we heading to such kind of leaders? Or we are creating yet another border within India, having Muslims on one side and Hindus on another side? And from Congress, I have a question. Does merely being born to Nehru family gives Rahul the right to seek election with no political credentials? Assume that he would be elected and aspire to be a PM or a senior minister.
Okay, two pointed questions. I'm glad you asked those questions, my friend. I'll go to R.P. Singh first and I'll come to you.
Praveen Tugaria is not part of BJP. I'm making it clear. He is no way associated with the BJP also. Just be very clear on this.
But he's part of the Sangh Parivar.
Sir, please allow me to say, What your grandfather would have said, or what your chacha, mama, taya would say, you're not responsible for that. Neither I'm responsible for that. Parveen Tagoria is not part of BJP at all. Let's be clear on this. On record, I'm saying so. I hope that makes your point clear. Second, as far as Giriraj Sharma said a statement, immediately he was snubbed and he was told that and that he can't, after the statement, Mr. Modi immediately dissociated himself from that statement of Mr. Giriraj Sharma. Giriraj. I hope that makes
he
it clear.
He was restrained by the EC, not by Mr. Modi.
Sir, let me complete. Even this behavior is abusive. As for me, even not like person to complete a statement, abusive behavior. I will not utter a word. But there's no way to behave also. In a debate, you don't allow, you gag a person is equivalent to abusive behavior.
Well, I think I highly disagree with you, sir. I've had many debates. I think more than you also, but Aman.
To what Mr. R.P. Singh is saying, he said that Mr. Modi took account of the situation and acted upon it. Then what happened in case of Amit Shah, who's his closest aide, who said things like who made a UP a hate election there and wanted people to vote as they, he said that it would
Rahul,
be. I'm coming back to that. I'll answer the question for sure. The thing is that Mr. Amit Shah made the situation very clear that his party wants the UP election to be turned into an election where hate and communalism comes into part of politics. To what you asked in regard to Mr. Rahul Gandhi, he has been a member of parliament for two terms. It is not correct to say that he's not holding any political credentials. He's worked inside the party. It is as important to strengthen your party
Credentials. Maybe the people are not buying the veracity of those credentials.
No. The thing is that what he has done for the party and what he has done inside the party, his credentials are out there in public domain. One can take account of things from the way he has actually shaped the youth congress.
That's the standard response. But the question itself proves somehow that has not been conveyed, or they are not convinced by it.
Even the Congress party is not convinced by it, some people.
Totally. Look at the way Priyanka has come out.
Yeah.
And she's making a greater impact than Rahul.
Okay. Diptosh, let me come to you for a very short question before I go back to the audience. Now, R.P. Singh says Praveen Togadia is not part of the BJP. Let's take him at face value. Let's agree to whatever he says.
Obviously.
Are we buying that?
Obviously, this is an old BJP trick game. Because everybody in the Sangh Parivar will say that RSS is not part of the political process. But we know that elections in UP, Bihar, elsewhere cannot be fought without the RSS being on the ground, without the VHP stepping into the ground. So obviously there are VHP workers who are on the ground. And these are, you know, nicely subtle way of putting words into this elections, inserting words into this electoral process, which Praveen Tokadia has done. And that is the reflection which Giriraj Mishra does also in
Giriraj Singh.
Giriraj Singh also does in Bihar.
Right. Okay. I want to ask the audience right now. You heard the answers of the participants here. Who agrees that be it anyone from the VHP or BJP or Bajrang Dal or not, or the Congress party, people like Rashid Masood, Imran Masood, people like Azam Khan from the Samajwadi party, Ramdev has been talking a lot of, I'm coming to you. He's been making a lot of noises today. Do you think, my question to you is, before you ask your question, my question to you is, people like these and the kind of vitriol they spew, are you okay with that as a young Indian, no matter where your political leanings lie?
See, my opinion regarding the whole session and the, you know, debate going on right now is whatever leader speaks, that image is created in our mind, you know, and whatever the leaders of the party, they are representing that party, okay? And, you know, if they cannot take that mature decision within their country, how will they represent their whole nation as a India outside India?
Now, if they're doing this before being elected, what will they do after being elected?
That's a very fantastic point.
My friend over there has a question. I'll come to you very quickly. What's your name?
My name is Varun, and my question is that we are currently result oriented, and seeing as a youth, we want result as jobs, as development. What is your answer to it? Taking the question to the
Let me supplement that. Diptosh, when this campaign started, especially the BJP wanted a development plan. They talked about only developmental issues. After phase 3 of these elections, the campaign suddenly changed, not just from the BJP, but from the Congress as well. They got personal. They got vitriolic. Why did that happen? Isn't that harming the BJP more than helping them?
Absolutely. Desperation has crept in all sides. I'm not saying, you know, it's very difficult to single out the BJP alone. You see, we have to realize a larger question here. The larger question is, look at the way Parliament functioned in the last 5 years. There was no cooperation at all between the government and the opposition. The opposition boycotted the Parliament every day. There's so many working crores were absolutely wasted. So what happens here is that we have a position of absolute non-cooperation again at this election. We know that the BJP, that the Congress has taken up a stand that Modi is a divisive leader. We will not even talk to him. And what is Modi doing? Modi is also preaching for a Congress Mukt Bharat. Does he want to absolutely remove, erase the opposition from this country? So, you know, this is the way both parties have taken up very strong, very stances which are absolutely will not brought to the middle ground.
Mr. R.P. Singh, do you agree with Dipto?
Three issues which Dipto said, I need to rebut them. First, again, I'm categorically saying Mr. Tagoria is no way part of BJP. I'm categorically saying. I'll appreciate the young audience. Please go to the internet. Sir, allow me to say, sir, allow me to say, now, sir, this is no way.
It's as good as saying,
you're a seasoned guy, please, I hope, you say, sir, allow me to say so, allow me to complete, why don't you, why are you gagging?
Okay,
sir, why are you gagging?
Go ahead.
We have to say in regard to Virat Singh and Amit Shah, even if not agreeing and assuming if what he's saying is correct, what he has to say in regard to Amit Shah?
Let Mr. Singh speak, then I'll come to you. Mr. Singh, 30 seconds to you.
Sir, I'll appreciate the young audience should go to internet and see how Mr. Tagoria has been always been pumped out of Gujarat. He never had any correlation with Mr. Modi.
Singh sir, if I could come in, if you allow me,
I'll come to Amit Shah also. Second. Now allow me to say second, sir. Second, you said we didn't cooperate for the parliament to move on. Sir, we also ran a government for 6 years. We went step forward and took full cooperation with Congress to run the parliament well. It's always the party who runs the government responsibility to take opposition in confidence and run the parliament. It's not us. We are supposed to.
It's a symbiotic relationship, sir. You're twisting politics the way we understand it. It's a symbiotic relationship.
Don't gag.
Nobody's gagging. I'm just trying to make a point, sir.
No.
Enough points. Audience, enough points, sir. I have questions. I know. I'm coming to you. First of all, sir.
Allow me
to interject, sir. I have a time constraint.
Allow me to complete. Sir, you don't raise. Then you don't raise questions. I'm not raising a single question about Congress.
You have to answer your questions, sir.
I'm not raising a single question about Congress. I'm not raising about Chaiwala. I'm not about personal life of Mr. Modi.
Okay.
Question with it. He was a chaiwala. What is the language you use? Chaiwala.
Like
sir, that is a level of debate.
Okay, you answered your questions. I'm going to take questions from the audience, Mr. Singh. Please be patient, sir, and please allow me to interject.
Allow me to answer.
Sure. I'll come to you. Many questions here. I can see hands over there. I'll come to you. But my point is, and by the time I reach there, I want you to think about a voice vote. My question is now, Mr. Singh says that Mr. Tagoria is not part of the BJP. We've disassociated with him. How many in the audience really believe that Mr. Tagoria has nothing to do with the BJP organization? Who believes that?
With BJP, yes.
Two people believe that, sir. The rest, do you agree with him? Yes or no?
No.
Sir, that's your answer. Yes, you had a question. I'm coming to you.
With the history of scams like CWG, why has the Congress not offered any clarification in its defense? Is it the admission to defense its guilt?
All right, one question, one more. Yes, people there. I'll come to you in a sense. Meanwhile, CWG, very important.
See, the thing is that in regard to having a curb on corruption, it is the Congress party which enacted the RTI. It was the Congress party which has got the Lokpal bill enacted in the parliament. We obviously, corruption is an existing issue in the society.
It's the biggest issue today, is it not?
We do acknowledge that. The thing is that are we acting upon it or are we not acting upon it?
We are acting upon it.
Something what that the entire young generation was fighting on the streets of Delhi and Gujarat does not have a Lokayukta.
Okay, one more question from the audience.
It was after the Supreme Court's intervention when a Lokayukta, spineless Lokayukta, was actually enacted in the state of Gujarat.
The party wants to divert our mind from political agendas like development by hate speeches and abusive language.
Yes, it seems like the party is doing that.
Not just one party. Who believes every political party has their hands dirty in these elections? People who agree will say yes.
See, we are in
every political party, sir. Every political party. The Congress is not away from it. The BJP can deny all it wants. Diptosh, the BJP, the Congress, the Samajwadi Party, the Baspa, name it. And you have
Farooq Abdullah.
Even Farooq Abdullah.
Who says anybody who votes for Modi will drown in a whatever sea. And then look at what Mamata calls Narendra Modi. Mamata calls him the butcher of Gujarat. Mamata's people do that. Derek O'Brien and all step out to do that. Look at the way, as I keep repeating what Hira said, the Rajasthan MLA said that Sonia should be stripped, Rahul should be stripped and paraded, and they should be, you know, deported back to Italy. Now, is that the language which we are expecting in this election?
Of course
this is
not.
The, one of the most abusive election ever. I've heard BJP campaigning in the ground, in the rural areas where I've travelled this election, where they're saying that Sonia Gandhi was the only person of the Gandhi family present in the house was when Indira Gandhi was murdered.
So why hasn't anyone knows?
Why hasn't she been charged?
Insinuations anyone knows? So before I come to you, sir, I want to ask the audience, people who have questions, please raise their hands. I also want to ask you whether you think we can do something about this abusive language spoken by the political parties. What is the way out? How can we teach our own politicians a lesson? There was a hand up here. Yes, what's your name?
Ajay Pratap Singh.
Yeah.
The option with us is nota, none of the above. Let them teach a lesson by not electing any one of them.
I would like to come in here.
Nota option, who agrees, is a good option. People, give a round of applause. Who agrees nota is a good option? I think 60% of the audience, by round of applause, meant that nota is a good option. Is nota the only way forward? I'll come to you, sir, after this.
See, nota is obviously a right given to the public at large that they have the right to reject all the above candidates. But at the end of the day, we need a government to represent the public at the center and at the state. So, to actually regulate all this, to actually change the discourse to policies and to past record and the performance of the candidates and not get into verbal spat, the only thing that needs to be done is there should be a gentleman's agreement between the candidates who are contesting with the law. And this is something which falls under the scope of self-regulation. You know, the candidates need to know, otherwise obviously the public will reject them.
No,
we are in between a highly charged political atmosphere.
Kind of campaign you've seen,
the entire campaign of the opposition's PM candidate did start with personal attacks, is based on personal attacks, and he's been using...
No, we can do this all night, Aman. The BJP will say it's the Congress fault.
No,
they started it.
If
you actually look at it, it was in 2002 when Narendra Modi was condemned by his own Prime Minister saying, when he highlighted the word James Michael Lingo,
I think two issues should be settled here. One, there is a limit to which you can go back to 2002, which keeps bringing back all these very, very vile abuses against Modi. And there is a limit to the reference of Sonia Gandhi's foreign origin, which has been settled once and for all.
Yes.
This is where the two parties should come together.
Of course.
Is where the two parties should be settled.
Do you think the gentleman's agreement like the one Aman mentioned is possible in this vitriolic charge campaign, sir?
Let's talk about one thing. Let's talk to the audience. This complete election by BJP was on developmental issues or not?
Yes. It started out.
Yes, you said to allow me to say.
Sir, you said something. You will develop the country. You're not talking about development at all. All his speeches are focused on personal attacks.
Aman, you had your chance. Mr. Singh's chance now.
Yes, chun ke khatam
kar sake. One second. Mr. Singh.
Who's saying this?
Aman, he has to speak now. Mr. Singh, go ahead.
I am shocked. I mean, why you want to gag? I'm not wasting time, sir. We are complete on development agenda. We never spoke about any personal issue or personal agenda. Who spoke about Mr. Modi's personal family? Mr. Rahul Gandhi and MIT spoke about Mr. Modi's personal issues or not?
Yes.
So, did we spoke about any personal issues and subjects? Did we spoke about any personal families and issues and subjects? So, do you expect our cadre not to come back on this? But even then, Mr. Modi has been categorically talking about only developmental issue. And for us, this development is a bigger issue. And for the lady concerned, ma'am, you should know this. Shumlu Committee was formed by Mr. Manmohan Singh, the Prime Minister. Shumlu Committee gave a report on Commonwealth Game, indicting Mrs. Sheila Dixit and Kalmadi. No action. It was dumped. Because it suited them.
No, sir.
Sir, no action. CAG said Commonwealth Game.
Injected, no action. 2G, no action. Colgate, no action. Only saying that we have given RTI, we'll give rights, doesn't work. Okay. But what is the action on ground?
Okay.
What
is the action on ground?
We still stand by the agenda for the youth of the country.
Let's go back.
What about the tinted minister, Mr. Modi, has in his cabinet? I think people should. No, no. If he is highlighting, if you are changing the discourse of the debate from verbal spat to corruption,
you're going to go back to the
I would like to ask him, why is he not doing anything about that? The topic is the most abusive election ever.
I have a question for the audience. I'll come to you also. But my question is, be it Rashid Masood, Imran Masood, whatever his name is, be it Azam Khan, be it Ramdev, be it Pravin Togadia, do you think people who are running for Prime Minister or aspiring to be the Prime Minister of the country or leading their own party into victory, do you think they should strongly, first of all, condemn and disassociate themselves with people like I have just mentioned? Do you think that these people end up hurting them more than helping them? People who believe that parties should disassociate themselves with statements and people like this will say yes in one voice.
Yes!
Resounding response. Resounding response. One question from this third.
Promotions in the BJP by speaking this language.
Yeah.
My question is for both of you, one for BJP and one for Congress. For BJP, the question is, you people are collecting votes in the name of Modi that he is going to be the Prime Minister, right? And do you think that we want a leader who is on the basis of physical aperture? He said that we want a leader who is having 64 in Sina and something like that. We don't want a person to be our leader who with only physical in bills. We want a person with the strategies in his mind, right?
So I think what she's trying to say is that you run a very good campaign, but
he's still left with the question of Congress.
No.
I'll answer. Don't worry.
Chapan ka Sina is what Mr. Modi had said, not the Congress candidate. You can't escape.
I'll answer that also.
Yeah, please. One more question for Congress.
The question is, you recently talked about Nota, right? According to Nota, even if there are 60% bogus vote, I mean, if 60% people opt for Nota, still the person who's getting 40% going to be the president or the prime minister or whatever you say. What's the use of Nota then?
See, Nota is at an evolving stage. Nota was an option given by a Supreme Court judgment. It wasn't introduced as an option to us by the virtue of the parliament. It was by the Supreme Court's judgment. The Nota is at an evolving stage. I'm sure that if the democracy at large rejects the candidate by a greater percentage, and obviously in the future course, then Nota will have a higher significance than the candidate actually being declared as the winning candidate.
I have a minute left on the show. I can't take more questions. I'll give them 10 seconds.
I need to answer that 56 inches.
Sir, 10
seconds. Are you sure you want to answer?
Only a minute left. Please don't interrupt.
As far as 56 inches goes, it's just for Pakistan. That comment is only for Pakistan, that we Indians have that much of, we can bear and we can come back to you.
So you can scare Pakistan with 56 inches.
Not only for Pakistan. That was only meant for Pakistan.
No. So you can scare Pakistan with 56 inches.
Yes, we don't mind. And secondly, Mr. Modi has been regularly talking about development of the issue.
Armed forces are there to take care of Pakistan.
One second. Okay, I don't have more time. I'll take two quick questions and then Diptosh will close the debate. You already asked a question. Ma'am, I'll come to you if I can. You already asked a question. Very quickly, if you can. Pass the mic, please. 10 seconds and less.
I have a question for both the parties. In fact, all the national parties. You're all putting up your own fronts and your own arguments. What do you think these arguments and this kind of dispute is doing to the entire Indian electorate? And then we also are putting up a face in front of the entire global world. What do you think
Fantastic
this kind
point.
Of a thing...
The whole world is watching us.
Answer that.
The whole world is watching us and this is what we are doing. Ma'am, if I could have the mic, I'm very short on time. Diptosh, I'll take one more question, then you close the debate. One more question. Hands, please. Yes, what have you already spoken? Someone who hasn't spoken yet. You have spoken. Last question of the show.
Well, I am a teacher and I want to know whether shall I go to the class asking who is Hindu and who is Muslim and
not.
Abusing them?
Of course not. Of course not.
That sentiment, Diptosh, is what I want to close on. Aman, I don't have any time. That sentiment that Mr. What's your name, sir?
Sabyasachi.
Sabyasachi said right now. I couldn't agree more with him.
Some of our best friends are Muslim.
One second, Aman. It's not about Hindu-Muslim. It's not about Hindu-Muslim. It's not about Hindu-Muslim.
No nota. Please vote by your choice.
Diptosh.
No, don't go.
Mr. Singh, please.
No nota.
Mr. Singh, you have enough time. You vote. Aman and Mr. Singh, Diptosh will close the debate now.
Just before I came to the show, I was reading a particular article which has been published in Economic and Political Weekly about a week ago. Which are the states which vote on the basis of caste and religion the most? And the answers are horrible. And people want to find out the religion of their candidates before they vote for them. This is a subconscious, you know, at the subconscious level, this prevails across this country. And if we play around with it, as most of our politicians do, and not just the BJP, don't blame the BJP alone. The Congress also does it. And Samajwadi Party. All these parties, they play around with religion. And they have to be careful. They are leading us to a precipice where a civil war will break out in this country.
Okay, on that note, I will ask only one thing of my audience before I close the show. What Mr. Sabyasachi said and what Diptosh said right now. After all, once we start distinguishing amongst each other on the basis of religion and caste, this is 21st century India, for God's sake. People who agree that this has to stop now, right here, will say yes.
Yes.
That is JRE Institute. Many thanks to our panelists. I must thank all the people who came here. RP Singh of the BJP, please give him a huge round of applause. Diptosh Majumdar, National Affairs Editor, NewsX. Aman Pawar of the Congress Party. The biggest round of applause you should stay for yourself because you have made my day today. Many thanks for giving us space and time. That is JRE Institute and this is Campus Connect. My name is Athar Khan. Good night.